Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Destiny. I am Death from Above. I want to talk about a gun that I think has been ignored, and I really like it. So today we're going to look at the Hake Lyadmila D Pulse Rifle, do a little PvP live com where I extol the virtues of this gun that I have such a fondness for. So the Hake Lyadmila D is a high impact, low rate of fire pulse rifle from Hake. What is he doing? Oh, he got me. So, it is a high impact, low rate of fire pulse rifle from Hake. You get it from a gunsmith package or from ranking up the gunsmith. So, foundry order or gunsmith rank. Now, I've got what I would think is a god roll. I've got glass half full, counterbalance, hand laid stock. So, I've got decent range, good damage, and great stability. So I've got the LC range scope. We can also use the GA post if we so decide, which I think we're going to do that on this map. The reason I think most people don't use this gun is because of its archetype. It's a high impact, low rate of fire pulse rifle that people don't really like using anymore. Are you really thorning me? I will shoot you in the face so hard you won't even know what happened. But people don't really use the Lyadmila D because of the archetype. It's kind of the forgotten pulse rifle archetype. After they did some changes in the April 2.2 update and updates before it, this kind of became a gun that most people don't use. Just because it has a slower time to kill perceived, which it really honestly is slower time to kill than... Jeez, the thorn, man. The time to kill is really slower than like the Hawksaw and the Grass of Malak. I have to run now. Which is true if you're not hitting your shots. If you're getting all headshots with this thing, you're going to kill people real fast. It's a two-burst kill with the right setup. I think if the lower end of the glass half full is popping off, it is a two-burst kill with this guy. Are you? Okay. I'm getting shotgunned to death. One of the problems with this gun is you can't play run and gun with it. And that's my normal style of playing, is run and gun. You have to play back. You have to be conservative. You have to take those distance to shots. And that is your way to win. So, one of the things I'm having trouble with is figuring out the range on that. So, one of the things... Oh, he just telestoed me. One of the things people have a hard time with is using a gun that's not the meta if they're trying to win. Now, a lot of times, I'm just trying out new guns. I'm just playing. I'm just shooting stuff. I'm just having fun. So, I want to use all the guns. I want to see which ones are good. I want to see which ones I like. Which ones have good talents. Which ones have good abilities. Which ones are just fun and feel good? Now, this one feels odd if you're not used to a four-burst pulse rifle and if you're not used to a high-impact pulse rifle. It's just going to feel weird. You're going to use it. It takes a little bit longer to get used to, and you're just not going to enjoy it. So, you'll probably put it back. So, this one, though. Come on, baby. There's a kill. And the thorn. That guy's really enjoying that thorn. He's ready for year three. So, I'm a little out of practice with it. I have been using my PDX-45 mostly. So this is a cold live con where I pull out the Lyadmila D. I'm talking about how much I like it, but doing very poorly with it. But doesn't mean I don't like it. It's still a good gun. It's still a gun I enjoy. See if we can land those shots. See, if you land those shots, this guy's going to go down hard. So that was a three burst. The problem with these is they have no room for error, and I have a lot of error inherent in my playstyle. So you can't miss those shots, which I do miss those shots. Let's do a little fusioning. Where did he go? Oh gosh, there's so much happening right now. Die from the burn. Okay. But the Hake Lyadmila D is one of the guns I got very early on in the Taken King. I got it back at the very beginning when the gunsmith was just doing his thing. And I really liked it. I liked the I feel like it's a calm gun for me. You have to have a calm trigger finger to use this gun. Now, you can use it at pretty good range, and it's not going to be that bad. See if we can get him with a trip mine. Oh, he is not paying attention. We're going to disable this. But it's a calm gun. I like using these guns because you can play back, have a little fun, relax, not worry as much about running a gun and getting that top KD. Getting the massive amounts of kills. But play back, be a team player. This guy and his Grapes of Wrath, I can't stand it. But you play back, be a good team player. You're going to go for, instead of going for all the kills, you need to have the PvP mindset of don't die. Play back, don't die, don't give the other team points, and you can get some range out of it. That's right, you better back off. That grenade was perfectly placed. Don't even doubt it. It's gonna stay there for later. Don't worry, I'm wearing the Ahamkara arm things. I just ran right past my roommate. Come on, come here, roommate. Oh, I was gonna get you, roomie. Come on, bro. Let's fusion a little bit. Well, he's not playing. All right, golden gun and heavy ammo is available. Those guys are coming with the heavy. There's a rocket. Oh, I thought it was a truth. But the Hockey Live Melody is coming this week as a Foundry order. If you picked it up, hopefully you'll get something. Headseeker's very good on this. Headseeker, glass half full. Anything that boosts the damage because it's such high impact already. Oh, man, you don't know me. Okay, he does know me. But it's so high impact, anything that boosts damage is going to give you a really good punch. Because it is high impact, and it does have a very large mag. Don't forget how big the mag is on the pulse rifles. They boosted those early on in year 2, or maybe in year 1, I can't remember exactly. And they have benefited greatly from it. So, got lots of room for activities. This guy right now. Oh, he jumped. He jumped over me. This guy is just, he's got my number right now. So don't take the gameplay as a direct correlation of how good the gun is. Just notice the times when I use it effectively, how I use it, and just kind of what I'm doing about it. So basically, don't use me as a barometer. I'm a liar, and I'm not good at the game. That's what I said. I did. But no, it's a fun. Oh my gosh! I ran right into that. So the Lion Mila D. A lot of fun. I do have a special place in my heart for this gun for some reason. I don't even understand why. The two Hake pulse rifles, or Haka Heka, the Lion Mila D, and the, I can't remember the other one, the Herja D. They just, for some reason, are special to me. I really enjoy them. I really like them. I've used them for a long time. We're going to go ahead and switch to the range scope, see if that helps me out a little bit if I don't die in the middle of doing this. So anything with range on this is going to be very interesting. Oh, hi. Did you want some golden gun? I think you... What? I'm sorry. I shot that guy. I'm sorry, Bungie. I'm going to have to say that I shot that guy. So, I love how I can disagree with a video game, but they're, you know, you can't really disagree with a video game. So, Hake, Lion Mila D. Use it almost like a scout rifle. It's going to have that decent range. It's going to have pretty decent range just because it is low rate of fire, high impact. Where are you at? There you are. I got... You want to peek? You didn't, but I did. Oh, dang it. The grapes. Again. We got to run from the grapes. Oh, that grenade almost killed him. Oh, wanted a doobla down. Oh, he was behind me. So this is the part of the video where it turns into a live com. But, Hockey Lion Mila D, live com PvP. Get it. I like it. It's good. Look for something that boosts damage and maybe some counterbalance or some brace frame or some hand laid stock. You want stability because the kick pattern without stability is pretty bad. And a damage. Maybe crowd control is not bad. Crowd control is decent. I prefer glass half full or head seeker. Oh, hello. Hi. I'll take that party crasher with range finder. Well, I think we're going to extend this video a few more seconds. Wait, let's make sure I have room in my inventory for it. I do not. Now I do. Alright, let's make sure it transfers. Alright, we're going to grab a party crasher with rangefinder. Guys, welcome. Welcome to the end of the video that I did not expect. Party crasher with rangefinder. Let's check what that other guy's gun was. I saw two legendaries drop. Welcome to the perfect live com. You have a decent live com, and then at the end you're rewarded with a wonderful gun. Let's check out that last guy's gun. Can we look at it? What did he get? Okay, he got a Hot Swap Army of One Red Spectre. I'd say I came out on top on this deal. So, Rangefinder Replenish. What do we got here? Flared Magwell, Quick Draw. Oh, if only it had Rifled Barrel. Quick Draw's not bad, though. Replenish, Quick Draw, Rangefinder. Guys, what do you think about this? Field Choke, what do you think about this? Is this good? Did I do well? Let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching, guys. This was about the Lion Melody, and it became a Party Crasher video. We got the party crashed by a shotgun. So let me know what you think in the comments, and thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. I'm Death From Above. Until next time, leave a like if you've enjoyed this, subscribe if you want to see more, and I'm Death From Above, and I'll see you later. See ya, bye.